We've all heard of white-collar crimes, but usually the white collar does not belong to a bishop of the Roman Catholic Church. The verdict is in, and it's a split decision for Robert Finn of the Kansas City St. Joseph Diocese. Convicted on one misdemeanor count of failing to report suspicions of child abuse, the bishop was acquitted on the other. Two more counts were dropped. Finn was sentenced to 2 years of probation, then the sentence was suspended by Judge John Torrance. Ultimately, Finn's future as bishop will likely be determined by Rome, but Mary, will local opinion and local reaction be of any consequence?
Well, historically, Catholic people have nothing to say at all about whether or not bishops, I mean, in recent history, meaning the last 1,500 years. That's accurate, actually. So there isn't anything really that Catholic people in their parishes can do to force him to resign or to get the Pope to act. I suppose there are people in Kansas City who are powerful with the Pope. I don't know about that. On the other hand, there are petitions that have begun to be circulated. One today I got was from St. Peter's Parish. There are people, most Catholic people have very strong feelings about what the bishop failed to do. And this long, agonizing scandal, this has been going on now for decades, about whether the sexual assault of children in the Catholic Church will stop. And finally, one bishop in the United States has been convicted of not following the law, albeit on a misdemeanor.
And let's point out, he did not abuse children himself. He's not accused of that.
What he did, Mike, was
failed to report suspicions of sexual abuse.
Which he was very familiar with. You know that 4 years ago, he signed an agreement, a $12 million agreement with 47 parents. And promised to report things to the police. Now, Jean Peters Baker, the Jackson County prosecutor, did not push this farther because she knew that she would have to put photos of these children's bodies up in the court. And having spoken to her about this in newspaper accounts, you know, the reasons why he just got probation, the judge suspended. But he will have to, there will be opportunities.
He's got several things he has to do
to report
comply
to
with the court's order.
And if there's any problem, he will be have real trouble with the judge.
I think, Mary, you hit, for me, the nail on the head when you talked about this has been years and years of controversy.
Long time.
Very well known. Signed the agreement. In other words, fool me once, well, you know, shame on you, but fool me twice, shame on me. And in this case, this is why the Star, and I guess myself personally, just think, getting rid of Bishop Finn would be a do-over for the Catholic Diocese here.
Oh, yes.
It would be good. You wouldn't have all these other questions here. He wouldn't, you know, he could be doing all his monitoring and all that kind of stuff. But I guess that's the part that really hits me hardest is that when given the warning, you have to do better, he did not. And I'm sorry, I don't cut the prosecutor that much slack on this one. You know, I know she had all these excuses for not pursuing him more. Her public explanation did not wash. There must have been something more.
Yale, well, there's a judge and a prosecutor in this case.
Yeah.
That's a very important thing to remember.
Yeah.
Well, the case
judge
is not
tell her how to prosecute her
exactly.
case.
No. Exactly.
I'm lying that.
No, but there,
she,
look,
I think there's
a,
I did not go back. I'm familiar with this statute. I didn't go back and look at when we talked about this months ago about exactly who was precisely covered in it, and priests are precisely covered.
But at the time, you thought Bishop Finn was not covered by it.
Right, and he clearly is in the language of statute.
Yes.
What is unclear in the statute is what constitutes a reasonable suspicion of child abuse. Mm-hmm. And not that this case wouldn't clearly fit any definition, but that the statute could be attacked for vagueness and the whole statute be pitched out. And that is a risk that I believe the prosecutor had to look at, and it's real. Now, let me say my position. If I were the Pope, this guy would not be the bishop tomorrow, and I'd pull him out of here. And I think there's a resistance in the Vatican because they know how happy people like Mary are going to be. And the solution to that is to send in another bishop.
That's not fair.
Well, another bishop who will make her just as unhappy on better grounds.
Your Holiness, hang on a second. Gwen.
Yeah.
You know, irrespective of how she tried the case, you have to give her credit for getting a guilty verdict.
You're talking about the prosecutor.
I'm talking about Jean Peters Baker. She she pursued the case when the Clay County prosecutor would not. She did achieve a guilty verdict. It's unfortunate that the judge pretty much overturned it with this probation piece, but still, you know, if he is able to get his record expunged, he will not be successful in expunging the memories of everyone who knew that he failed to protect
those
children.
I would like to respond to, if I can, just because it's very personal to me, Woody. I mean, you know, it's very personal to me for this reason. I taught in Catholic schools for many years. As you know, I'm a former Catholic nun, and I am very much Catholic. So for those of us in the Catholic Church, there is no good news about this. This is about little girls and what was done to them and who was held responsible. And nobody thinks that's a great, happy story, least of all me.
Finn was controversial before this whole matter arose, and there were people who, because of theological differences, wanted him out as bishop.
That has nothing to do with
No, I say before this whole matter,
he will be happy if they get a bishop they agree with.
Exactly.
Every bishop is controversial in some way.
I mean, for just personally, that didn't have, I'm just telling Drew, that had nothing to do with my personal feelings about it.
No, my point was, before all of this, before this issue arose involving Finn, he was controversial within the diocese. Yeah. There were those who didn't like
Every
his brand of theology. He's more conservative.
I wish he'd been more conservative in the right
way. In terms of his theology,
in
terms of his theology, than many in the
liberal on the law.
He should resign.
Well, can you? Can he just walk out?
He can't. He can't resign.
You can't resign. Oh, please.
The only
well, you can't.
Can you quit? I mean, you can't retire.
I don't know.
The only.